Hello and welcome to Learn Statistics class. In this class, we are going to learn the statistical concept in simple and more easy way. The topic of today's lecture is how to obtain the value of mode graphically. So, let us start with obtain the mode graphically. In order to obtain mode graphically, first draw the histogram. We obtain the mode with the help of histogram. Since mode is the atom with maximum frequency, it lies in the rectangle with maximum height. To find mode, connect the right hand top corner of the rectangle of maximum height with the top right corner of the previous rectangle with a straight line. This means first we draw the histogram and search a rectangle with maximum height. After that, connect the right hand top corner of the rectangle of maximum height with the right hand top corner of a rectangle, previous rectangle means previous to the maximum height rectangle with a straight line. After that, connect the left hand top corner of rectangle with maximum height with left hand top corner of the rectangle which is next to the maximum height rectangle with the help of a straight line. After connecting these two corners, draw a perpendicular from the point of intersection of these two lines to meet the x-axis and read the x-coordinate of that point of intersection. This is the value of mode. Now we will take one example to understand how to obtain mode graphically with the help of a histogram. Consider the example. Construct a histogram and determine the value of mode from the following data. Here we have given weight in kilogram and number of students. Weights are expressed in the classes 30 to 40, 40, 50, like that up to 80 to 90, and the number of students following their respective classes are also given. Solution. In order to obtain mode, first we draw the histogram. To draw the histogram, there are four methods, different methods, which we have discussed in the Learn Statistics platform in the previous lectures. I will not going in detail the four methods of drawing of histogram. If a student want to learn in detail how to draw or construct a histogram in the different methods, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that two lectures are also mentioned in the description box. In our example, classes are of equal width, means each class has width 10. So we are going to use the first method which we have discussed in the previous lectures. In such a case, take the classes along the x-axis and the number of students along the y-axis in order to construct a histogram. Let us see the histogram which we have drawn already by taking weight in kilogram along the x-axis and number of students along the y-axis. By carefully observing the histogram, we search one rectangle with maximum height and which is equal to 45. Now, our actual procedure starts from this. After searching a rectangle with maximum height, connect a right hand top corner of the rectangle with the right hand top corner of the previous rectangle. Previous rectangle is this one having height 37 with the help of a straight line. So let us draw a straight line. This is the line which connect the right hand top corner of a rectangle with maximum height with the right hand top corner of the rectangle which is previous to the maximum height rectangle. Similarly, the next step is connect the left hand top corner of a maximum rectangle with the next rectangle's left hand top corner. This is the next rectangle which has the height 27. So let us connect the left hand top corners. This is the line of joining the left hand top corners. After doing this, let us search a point of intersection. This is the point of intersection of these two respective lines. Then draw a perpendicular from the point of intersection on the x-axis and read the x-coordinate of that point of intersection. So we first draw a perpendicular line from the point of intersection on the x-axis. This is our perpendicular on x-axis. Now read the x-coordinate of this perpendicular, foot of perpendicular. Here the value is, I think it is 53, and this is the value of our corresponding mode. Student can write the straight lines with the help of your scale. I have drawn it with a free hand, so the lines are not looking straight line. Hence the mode equal to, in our example, x coordinate of foot of perpendicular, which is equal to 53. This is the value of mode which is obtained graphically. In this way, in this lecture, we learn how to obtain the value of mode graphically. In the previous lecture, we have already learned the various formulae of mode in case of individual data, discrete data and continuous data. And the examples on these three types of data are already discussed on the Learn Statistics platform. If a student want to learn that examples, then click on the I button at the top right corner, and link of that playlist is also mentioned in the description below. In the Learn Statistics channel, many more topics are already covered, and link of all the chapters are mentioned in the description, which is given in the below of video. If student like this lecture, click on the like button, share with your classmates to learn the statistics subject in simple and more easy way. We will meet in the next lecture with the next concept from the subject statistics. Till then, we will stop here. Thank you.